Anyone who has attempted to add mathematical expressions within WordPress will attest to the fact that it's not easy. Jetpack has made it a little bit easier. Jetpack is a plugin that you can enable on your blog in the Commons by going into Plugins here and then activating Jetpack. Jetpack adds a host of different features to your blog, one of which is the beautiful Math LaTeX markup language. Now, still, you end up needing to do what almost looks like complex coding in order to get your expression to load into a post. I'm going to share today a way for you to make that a little bit easier. You need to be using a Chrome browser, and when you're doing that, then if you sign in to the Chrome browser, you will be able to search the Chrome Web Store. So if you look here, if I create a new tab, I've got either my recently closed web pages or the Chrome Web Store here up top here, an option to sign in. I'm signed in already. You do that. If you search for either education, you'll find a number of different apps that are pretty fantastic for your browser. But the one we're looking for, it's very popular, so it shows up on the main page, but you could also search for it, is called the DAUM, DAUM Math Equation Editor. Of course, I'm looking for it here, but I've installed it, so it's not going to show up because it's already here. There, the DAUM Equation Editor. And with that app, once I launch that app, it will advertise to me. It's a free app. But what I end up with now is a much easier way to create my LaTeX code string. So if I'm looking here, if I needed a fraction, and then of course I can type 1/2, perhaps it's less than. And as I'm doing this, oh, sorry, I didn't want to be in there. I want to be done there. So I want my less than there. So as I'm working out what it looks like visually, down here in the bottom, I end up with the LaTeX string of code. If I take that now and copy it, and then go into a new post within the Commons, if I put that code in between square short code brackets that say LaTeX and the code, and then square bracket slash LaTeX, which, if you're looking to get back there, if we learn more here about LaTeX, you'll notice that's illustrated here to include that. If I do that, and then I save that draft and preview those changes, what I will end up with is the equation I laid out here in a new post, which I can then publish on my blog. We'll just preview that really quickly here. And there's that LaTeX code laid out in my blog. Hope that helps those of you who are trying to add some mathematical sentences into your blog post and struggling with the LaTeX encoder.